The brown tide was the scourge of Long Island's South Shore Islanders back in the 1980s and early 90s. It's been a few years since we've actually had a bad occurrence of it on Great South Bay, but this year, it's back with a vengeance. Hi, I'm Newsday Outdoors columnist Tom Schlichter, and with me today is Chris Gobler from Stony Brook University, an expert on brown tide. Chris, can you tell me a little bit about the brown tide?
Sure. Well, it's a microalgae or a phytoplankton, and this year it's grown very intense starting in April, spreading all through Great South Bay during the month of May, and as you can see, it's still a big problem here in June. The brown tide is toxic to a lot of shellfish. It can kill off scallops. We also know it's very harmful to hard clams, and probably is responsible for some of the loss of hard clams in Great South Bay. And you can see with the water as dark as it is, it clouds the bottom and it kills off any plants that might grow on the bottom of the bays, like eelgrass.
What are the factors, do you think, that brought it about this year, since it'd been since the year 2000 before we'd had it again?
Well, we know that the month of April was a lot warmer than usual, and we had about a three-week period without any rain, just sunny and clear. And we think that was probably an important factor in the bloom starting there. And once the brown tide takes off, there's not a lot that can stop it, except for very high temperatures.
And what temperature starts to kick the brown tide back down?
Well, usually when the bay hits the high 70s, low 80s or so, that's when you start seeing the brown tide going away.
Is the brown tide dangerous to finfish at all?
We don't think so. However, we do know that fish, as you know, are visual predators. Mm-hmm. And when they can't see, a lot of them may move out of the bay until they get to clearer waters where they can find prey items.
Now, as Chris mentioned, the brown tide is not necessarily harmful to finfish. That means you can still pull some bass, blues, weakfish, and fluke out of this brown, dingy water. How do you do that? Borrow a page from the freshwater guys. They're used to fishing in discolored water. Work with lures that are bright and loud or noisy. This rattle trap has BBs inside, and the fish can hear that from a long distance. Large profile lures, like this yellow bottle plug, show up well and create a lot of splash on the surface. Bigger lures are easier to see than smaller lures. To create the optimum amount of splash and draw fish in from a distance, try a big, wide-faced popper. Bright yellow, white, and blue are great colors. If you plan to probe the bottom for fluke or stripers, big, juicy bucktails with a wide profile are good. Try black. It's a color that shows up well in any condition. Bright pink also works, especially for weakfish and school bass. So Chris, tell me, where are some of the places around Long Island where the brown tide is least right now?
Well, along the South Shore bays, really the only places you can go where the water is clear is by the inlets. So whether you go to the Fire Island Inlet, Mauritius Inlet, or Shinnecock Inlet, the water's clear there, but as soon as you move away from those areas, the brown tide starts getting intense again.
And where could we expect it to be worst?
It's probably worse not far from here. That Robert Moses Bridge is usually, and historically, but also right now, where it's usually the worst.
And what will it take for the brown tide to clear up this summer?
Usually it's the high peak summer temperature. So I'm hoping and anticipating that once we hit July and into August, the bay's going to heat up enough and the brown tide can't hack that and it'll start to die off.
Waiting for the brown tide to fade and the clean water of a flood tide to roll in here to Babylon Town Dock, I'm Outdoor Tom for Newsday.com.